Appearing before Justice Alex Ajiji as Prosecution Witness 13, Dr. Moses Byaruhanga told court that when police recovered the body of the late Susan Magara, it was taken to the city mortuary where an autopsy was conducted. Alongside Dr. Sam Kaziwe, the pathologist discovered that two of Magara's fingers had been cut off and other injuries on different body parts.
The time we examined the body, she had been dead for at least more than 12 hours.
Byaruhanga further disclosed that the late Magara also had injuries in her chest and the stomach. The pathology report conducted on the 27th of February 2018 indicated that Magara died as a result of lack of oxygen. It is probable that she was suffocated before her body was tied in a polythene bag and dumped on the roadside where it was recovered.
There was blood-stained froth, a foam. There was a blood-stained foam on the nose and the mouth. Yes, my lord. Cyanosed lips. Lips. The lips were cyanosed. Cyanosis, my lord, means when you die in a condition where there is less oxygen, some parts of the body change color, so they become purplish.
After his testimony, prosecution brought in another witness, Dr. Musa Kiria from the Government Analytical Labs, but he was rejected by the defense lawyers, claiming that they had only been informed of one witness. Consequently, Justice Ajiji adjourned the matter to the 11th of December 2023 for further hearing. There are 9 suspects in this case, and these include Lubega Yusuf, Hussein Waswa, Muzamiru Sali, Abeka Chewolia, Mahad Kisalita, Kato Hassan Miro, Ismail Bukenya, Bufumbo Musa, and Hajara Nakandi. They are represented by lawyers Kumbuga Richard, Peter Wanda, Nabu Kenya Isha, and John Kabagambe, while the state is represented by Senior State Attorney Irene Nachimbugwe. Still in court, 3 people, including Patricia Kankwanza, the daughter of city businessman Henry Katanga, who was found dead last week, have been arraigned in court and charged with destroying evidence. Two other people, including Dr. Charles Otai and George Amanyire, were also charged with the same offense. The same charge sheet had Katanga's widow, Molly Katanga, and her 29-year-old daughter charged with murder. The duo was, however, not in court on grounds that they were both hospitalized. Katanga died on November 2nd following an alleged fight with his wife. His body was later discovered by police at their home in Embuya. Prosecution states that on the same day, Patricia Kankwanza, with the help of her siblings, removed a number of items from the scene of crime, well knowing that these will be required in judicial proceedings. Meanwhile, the Court of Appeal in Arua has kicked off a hearing of over 30 cases as it strives to dispose of these cases that have been pending for several years. Led by the Deputy Chief Justice and the head of the Court of Appeal, Justice Richard Butera, the Court of Appeal sessions commenced at Arua High Court Circuit in West Nile. Justice Butera called for alternative dispute resolution mechanisms to save court's resources. The trial justices of the Court of Appeal in Arua will include Justice Geoffrey Kiriabwire, Honorable Lady Justice Irene Muliagunja, and Honorable Lady Justice Eva Luswata. Among the cases to be determined are 13 murder cases, 13 defilement cases, 13 robbery cases, among others.
Well, the work plan for the work edition is that we should have growth at every level. We get from 9 judges at the Supreme Court to 26 for the Court of Appeal. The Court of Appeal, where for the High Court, from currently there are 81 judges, but we hope to increase that number to 156. And for the magistrates, as you already know, the numbers are growing.